زادك الأيام فتى وتمحى.
So Al-Allamah Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah in his kitab Jala'u Al-Afham, he mentions that the word al, it comes in four meanings, in those four meanings. So go to his Jala'u Al-Afham, page 737, the Taba' of Dar ibn al-Jawzi, Taba' that is there for you, it's page 737. وَأَصْحَابِ and his companions, the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the companions, brothers, it is مَنْ لَقِيَ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مُؤْمِنًا بِهِ وَمَاتَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. A companion is anyone who met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he died upon iman, even if he apostated for a period of time, it doesn't matter, as long as he died upon iman. But he met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَسَلَّمَ تَسْلِيمًا مَزِيدًا. The Shaykh said, وَسَلَّمَ تَسْلِيمًا مَزِيدًا. The word as-salam in the Arabic language, it means at-tahiyya, it's a greeting. It also means as-salamatu min an-naqaisi wal-radha'ili. It is to be protected and to be safe from any deficiency. To be safe from any deficiency. The Shaykh said, وَسَلَّمَ تَسْلِيمًا مَزِيدًا. مَزِيدًا is an ism maf'ul. It's an ism maf'ul that comes from the word ziyada. And the word ziyada, brothers, is what? هُوَ النُّمُو. It's something to grow extra, in additional. You see? And the Shaykh rahimahullah, as you can see, he combined between what? As-salati and salam. He combined between the two, salah and salam. And that is imtithala liqawlihi ta'ala. He is following the command of Allah. Because Allah said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Surah Al-Ahzab, ayah 56. Then the Shaykh said, Amma ba'du. To proceed. The word amma ba'du is a word that is used or it's brought lil intiqali min uslubin akhara. It is when you are moving from one form of a speech to another type of speech that you want to move on to. In other words, it means mahma, however the matter may be, or whatever the case is. That's what amma ba'du means. Whatever the case is. مَهْمَا يَكُنْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ whatever the matter may be. And it's recommended for the person to come with it. And the reason why it's recommended to come with it is because the messenger used to come with it. In his khutabs, his sermons, his mukatabat, his letters. So you doing this is following the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Shaykh said, أَمَّا بَعْدُ فَهَذَا. The word hadha here is an ishara. It's an ishara. Meaning the Shaykh is pointing at something. This ishara can be one of two. The hadha. It can be an ishara which is hissi, a tangible thing. It can be actually, when he's pointing at something, it can be something that is present and it's there and he's pointing at it. And that is, when is it tangible? If he wrote the muqaddimah first, are you there? If he wrote the muqaddimah first, and then he came to the book. No, sorry. If he wrote the muqaddimah last, and he wrote the book first. If he wrote the book already, and now he's writing the muqaddimah after he wrote the book, because some scholars, they do that, then the hadha is going towards the book that's already written. So he's saying this book. Or it can sometimes be what? Or sometimes it can mean that he's not. He's actually writing it the way we're reading it. He's writing the muqaddimah. The book is not yet written. And the muqaddimah is first written. So where does the hadha go towards? It goes towards what's in his brain. He's saying, hadha, that which is my brain that I'm going to write. Is what? Fahadha, that which is in my brain. This risala that I have in my mind. Or if he's already written the book, then it means hadha, this book that I've written. Yeah, ihtawat, it consists of. عليه من العقائد الإيمانية التي أجملها It consists of the عقيدة أهل السنة اعتقاد الفرقة الناجية المنصورة إلى قيام الساعة It consists of the اعتقاد The word اعتقاد is a مصدر is a verbal noun اعتقاد is a مصدر From what? From اعتقاد Is when somebody makes something what? إذا اتخذه عقيدة If somebody makes something their عقيدة, their belief والعقيدة هي ما يعقد عليه المرء قلبه An عقيدة is the knot that a person makes in his heart The knot Are you with me? لذلك that's why you would say اعتقدت كذا I believed in this Meaning عقدت عليه القلب والضمير My heart and internally I have tied this thought to my mind And it originally comes from the root word or originally comes from the usage of the Arabs when they say عقد الحبل He had made a knot on the rope إذا ربطه When you tie it And then it got used in that which is inside the heart of a person ثم استعمل and then it started to be used في عقيدة القلب the عقيدة the knot that a person makes in their heart وتصميمه الجازم now one or an ignorant person who doesn't understand would say the عقيدة doesn't exist in the Quran and it has no place in the Quran there's no such thing as عقيدة in the Quran وهذا And this, إن كان يدل على الشيء, if it indicates something to us, and if we can take something from that person's statement, we take from it their ignorance. يدل على جهله, it shows his ignorance and his lack of understanding of the Arabic language. Or more like, his lack of understanding of the book of Allah. نعم, that's the reality. Why? Because the word, it came in the Quran. In its original essence, of course. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أوفوا بالعقود. Oh, those of you who believe, أوفوا بالعقود. Stick to the covenants and the oaths that you have made. The word that has been used here is عقود. The مفسرين they took two views regarding يا أيها الذين آمنوا أوفوا بالعقود. They have taken two stances regarding it. The مفسرين when it came to the ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا أوفوا بالعقود. They took how many stances? They took two views. One view, that it means the عقود here, it means the ones that are done with the oaths that are made with the creation. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أوفوا بالعقود. And the other view is that the عقود here, it means the ones that were made with Allah تبارك وتعالى. That which we made with Allah. What was the عقد that everybody made with Allah تبارك وتعالى? أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَى Allah said to the people أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ Am I not your Lord? This was a عقد a covenant and a oath that you made with Allah إذن عقيدة So قرن بعد قرن generations after generations علماء used that word عقيدة Look at Imam الصابوني Imam الصابوني أبو عثمان الصابوني رحمه الله من أئمة السلف He used what? عقيدة السلف وأصحاب الحديث أبو قاسم هبة الله إلى لكائي What did he call his book? أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة What do you call it? أبو بكر الإسماعيلي رحمه الله عقيدة السلف call this one اعتقاد أئمة السلف You see, this word عقيدة was used before Rather أبو قاسم هبة الله إلى لكائي in his book أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة He talks in his book Aqeedatu Shafi'i Aqeedah of so-and-so Aqeedah of so-and-so The word Aqeedah is my immati salaf Min immati salaf And his Aqeedah book is min masadir It's from the sources in which books of Aqeedah is taken from One of the sources of when we go back to Kutub al-Aqaid It's a masdar of Kutub al-Aqaid It's a source of the books of Aqeedah that are taken So, we live at a time of strange views being passed. So, amma ba'du, as to proceed. فَهَذَا اَعْتِقَادُ الْفِرْقَةِ النَّاجِيَةِ الْمَنْصُورَةِ إِلَىٰ قِيَمِ السَّاعَةِ فَهَذَا this is اعتقاد is the belief of who? الْفِرْقَةِ النَّاجِيَةِ The word firqa is ta'ifa or jama'ah. The word firqa is a ta'ifa or it's a jama'ah, a group. A group of people. And what does it mean here? Firqatun najiyah, the saved sect, the saved group, that's what it is. And najiyah means saved. What are they saved from? And najiyatun min adabillahi. They are saved from the punishment of Allah. They are saved from the hellfire. They are saved from the hellfire. And they are also saved from what? Min al-halak wa shururi fi dunya wal akhirah. In this dunya also. Also from this dunya, they are saved from what? The evil. Ideologies that are out there. Allah save them from it. And that word, ya, al-firqatu najiya, was taken from the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. Or that understanding was taken from the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The hadith which Bukhari and Muslim and Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah narrated, where the Prophet ﷺ he said, la tazalu ta'ifa. Pay attention. There will not remain except a group. Min ummati, from my ummah. Ala al-haqi, they are upon the truth. Mansurah, victories with them. They're being aided and supported by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Those people, la yadurruhum man khadalahum. This group, it will not harm them, the one who deceives them. Hatta ya'tiya amrullah, until the... In this hadith, in other wordings, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned to us, he said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم على ذلك. Allah told us that this, the ummah are three types in this hadith. You look for which one are you. This hadith tells us that the people are three types. The first one is, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق. Those who are apparent, ظاهرين على الحق. There's a group who are apparent on the haq. Ya, they are on the haq. They're calling to the haq. The second one is those who oppose them. They oppose them. The mukhalifin, opposition towards them. And the third one is those who deceive them. They're deceiving them. They are what? Deceiving them. لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم. The one who does خذلان, who deceives them, who tricks them, and the one who opposes them. He doesn't deceive them, he just opposes them. They both won't harm. Which one, who will they not harm? They will not harm the ones who are what? ظاهرين على الحق, who are apparent on the haq. Why? Because they have nusrah, victory from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have what? Victory and aid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, oh Allah, make us from those who are what? ظاهرين على الحق. This book that we're taking is the belief of that group. Who are ظاهرين على الحق. Who are apparent on the haq. So here we have to learn that claiming that you're on the haq, and claiming that you're the saved sect, and saying that you are, it's not just a mere claim. It requires what? Bayina. Proof. Show us. Let us see. Because claiming is the easiest means or easiest tool. Everyone knows it. It doesn't take a lot to claim. It's something everybody can do. You see, and they are given victory until the day of judgment. إِلَىٰ قِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ until the day of judgment. إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَرِثَ اللَّهُ الْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ عَلَيْهَا until Allah tabarak wa ta'ala takes over. Yeah? Until Allah tabarak wa ta'ala takes over this world. The Shaykh said, أَمَّا بَعْدُ فَهَذَا اَعْتِقَادُ الْفِرْقَةِ النَّاجِيَةِ الْمَنْصُورَةِ إِلَىٰ قِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ. And then the Shaykh said, أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَعَةِ. أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَعَةِ. So we say, how do we read Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah? There's two ways of doing I'rab if we go follow it. We can read it as two ways. We can say what? We can say Ahli, I make the lam a kasra. We can say that. Or we can say Ahlu as-Sunnah wal Jama'ah. If we say Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, then this is a badal. Because a badal of what? At-ta'ifati al-mansurati ila qiyam al-sa'ati. Didn't you just say that? Isn't it firqatun najiyati? It's a badal from firqatun najiyati. And we took the badal. It is from the tawabi'. From the four tawabi', correct? The atf, the sifa, the badal, and the tawkid. Those four are what? Tawabi'. They follow the alama of the thing that's before them. Sahih? So here, because it's a badal of i'tiqadi, i'tiqadu, al-firqati najiyati, what was the alama for it? A kasra, right? So ahli sunnati, you make it a kasra. That's one way you can go. وَيَجُوزُ الرَّفْعُ, you can make it marfu'. On what? If it's marfu', there's another i'rab for it. If it's a marfu', then it is a khabar. If there's a khabar, then where's the mubtada? Every khabar has to have a mubtada. We will say to you, the mubtada is mahzuf. It's hidden. So what is it then if it's hidden? It is hum. Hum ahlus sunnati wal jama'ah. So there's a hum there that's hidden. So we have two ways of doing i'rab. We can either make a kasra as a badal from the word al-firqati. That's one. Or, وَيَجُوزُ الرَّفْعُ, we can say ahlus sunnati wal jama'ah, which is what? أَنَّهُ خَبَرٌ لِمُبْتَدَئٍ مَحْذُوفٍ تَقْدِيرُهُ هُوَ. صح? Those are the two ways. So we said ahli, we mentioned what it means. Ahl means family. Ahl means what? Family. Rather, in the Arabic language, is when ahlu shay'i, the ahl of something is qarabatuhu. Those who are closest to you. Meaning, they are the closest, the family. The way they are the closest to you, these are the ones who are the family of the sunnah. Ahli sunnati. Sunnah means what? What does sunnah mean? Sunnah means, hiya tariqatu, it is the road, it's a path. Allati kana alayha rasulullah, it is the path in which the Prophet was upon. In terms of speech, min qawlihi wa af'alihi, and his actions, wa taqriratihi, and his consent, that which he consented to alayhi salatu wasalam. So it is the path. And that which the Prophet ﷺ was. Which path? His speeches, his actions, and that which he consented to. Meaning it was done in his presence, he saw it, and he never objected to it. It's a sunnah. Why were they called Ahlul Sunnah? Why are these people called Ahlul Sunnah? Sumul Ahlul Sunnati, the reason why they were called Ahlul Sunnah is because they attributed themselves to Ahlul Sunnah. They attributed themselves to what? لِانْتِسَابِهِمْ لِسُنَّةِ الرَّسُولِ. They attributed themselves to the sunnah. And they did not attribute themselves to what? Are you with me? One of two. One of two. The people, innovators, they used to attribute themselves to one of two things. Or they were attributed to one of two things. Either they were attributed to an individual or they were attributed to an ideology. A statement. Like for example, the Qadariya are attributed to the what? Qadariya is not a person. They were attributed to the statements that came out of their mouth that they were misguided in. So they were attributed to that. Or Murji'ah as well. They were attributed to this action of theirs. Because what did Hassan al-Basri say to Wasil ibn al-Ata'? He said, so that's Mu'tazila. Mu'tazila, what did he say to them? I'tazil anna. The Mu'tazila were given the name Mu'tazila because Wasil said, so Hassan al-Basri said to Wasil ibn al-Ata'. He said to him, I'tazil anna, get away from us, leave us. So the Mu'tazila was given there. The Murji'ah, why were they called Murji'ah? لأنهم أخروا العمل من الإيمان. Irja' means what? تأخيرul. The word irja' is to delay. They delayed the action from the iman. They took it out of the iman. That's why. You see, and sometimes they attribute it to an individual. Like the Jahmiyyah, Jahm ibn Safwan. Or they're attributed to the what? like the Asha'ira, they are attributed to Abul Hasan al-Ash'ari, an individual. You see, ahl-us-sunnah, when Imam Malik was asked, who are they? Imam Malik was asked, who are ahl-us-sunnah? Man ahl-us-sunnah? He said, they are those who do not have no nickname. They have no nickname, they don't have no group. And then Imam Malik then started to mention the groups that were there at that time. They're not Qadiriyin, they're not Jahmiyin, they're not. Ahl-us-sunnah don't have names that you don't find in the Nusus al-Wahyayn. You don't, their names are taken from the Kitab and Sunnah. You with me? They attribute themselves to what? They attribute themselves to not a particular individual. Or they don't attribute themselves to what? Or they don't attribute themselves to a statement. They don't. Very good. That is Ahlul Sunnah. The same way in which they attribute themselves to the Sunnah, they also attribute their actions to the Sunnah. I mean, they follow the Sunnah. What they say, what they do, everything is the Sunnah. They're also called Jama'ah. Ahlul Sunnah, we understood why they're called Al-Jama'ah. Jama'ah means they're united upon the Sunnah. They didn't just unite, but they united upon the Sunnah. So, هُمُ الَّذِينَ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَى الْحَقِّ. They united upon the Haqq. الثَّابِتِ بِالْكِتَابِ وَالسُنَّةِ. The Haqq that is affirmed from the Kitab and the Sunnah, they united upon it. United, they don't differ on that. وَلِذَلِكَ. That is why the word jama'ah is given to the Haqq, not to the number of people they are. Pay attention, that's why it's important. Because they unite upon the what? Haqq. And it doesn't matter if the number is little. لذلك Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, as Abu Qasim Hibatullah illa Laka'i narrated in Sharh Usul I'tiqad Ahli Sunnah Tiwal Jama'ah, Abu Shama in his Kitab Al-Ba'ithu ala inkari al-bid'i wal-hawadith, Al-Mizzi in his Tahdhib al-Kamal, Al-Albani in his Mishkat al-Masabi', Ibn Asakir in his Tariq Dimashqa, with a chain of narration bisanadin sahih, a chain of narration which is authentic. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, Al-jama'atu, the jama'ah is ma wafaq al-haq, that which is in accordance to the haq. Wa in kunta wahdaka, even if you're by yourself, fa innaka anta al-jama'atu hina idhin, you are the jama'ah then. You are the jama'ah. If the haq is with you, anta al-jama'ah. Anta al-jama'ah. Very good. The Shaykh goes on to say, Shaykh-ul-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. He said, وَهُوَ الْإِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَالْبَعْثِ بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ وَالْإِيمَانُ بِالْقَدَرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ. The Shaykh said, وَهُوَ. Where does this huwa go back to? Where does this dhamir go back to? This dhamir goes back to اِعْتِقَادُ الْفِرْقَةِ النَّاجِيَةِ. Take that pronoun back to Al-i'tiqadu al-firqati an-najiyah. Meaning this is the belief of the saved sect. What is their belief? Al-imanu is to believe. Iman linguistically means at-tasdiq. Waqil al-iqraru. Iman is said to be tasdiq, to believe. And it is also said iqrar. Iqrar. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in Surah Yusuf, وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُصَدِّقٍ لَنَا. So the iman here means musaddiq. The technical definition is what? أَنَّهُ قَوْلٌ بِاللِّسَانِ. It is a statement of the tongue. It is a statement of the tongue. وَالِاعْتِقَادُ بِالْقَلْبِ. And it's a belief in the heart. وَعَمَلٌ بِالْجَوَارِحِ. And it's an actions of the limb. This is the belief of Ahlul Sunnah pertaining to Iman. Ahlul Sunnah believe that the Iman is a statement of on the tongue. They also believe it's an i'tiqadun bil qalbi. It's a belief in the heart. وَعَمَلٌ بِالْجَوَارِحِ. And actions on the limb. And each and every one of them are a pillar in Iman. All of them are arkan, pillars that a person needs to come with. Of Iman. Very good. Now the Shaykh rahimahullah, he goes into the six arkanul iman sitta, the six pillars of iman, in which a person's iman does not exist whatsoever if they don't believe in all of these six. The kitab has indicated these six. The sunnah has indicated these six. And the ijma' of this ummah is unanimously agreed upon these six pillars. The first one is what? Al-Imanu is to believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. It is to believe in who? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Believing in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, it means, brothers, to believe in His uluhiyah. It is to believe in His rububiyyah. And it is to believe in His al-asma'i wa sifat. Let me break that down for you. It means that you believe Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Huh? You believe Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is alone. He's alone in creating, sustaining, and providing. It's the first one. The second one is, you believe He's the only one who is worthy of worship. And the third one is that you believe He is alone in His names and His attributes. That is al-imanu billahi. That is al-imanu billahi. The second one is al-imanu bil malaikati. To believe in the angels. It means that you believe in the existence, al-imanu bi wujudihim. You believe that the angels exist. And you also believe they are as Allah has told us, وَأَنَّهُمْ كَمَا وَصَفَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي كِتَابِ. And they are how Allah has described them in His book. How has Allah described them in His book? Allah told us they are what? عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. They are righteous slaves of Allah. لَا يَسْبِقُونَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ وَهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِ يَعْمَلُونَ. That they do not precede Allah with any speech. And they are those who follow and implement His commands. And also the sunnah has also, and the kitab as well, have both told us that the angels are of different types and categories. And their descriptions are different. And they also have been delegated and given different responsibilities. We have to believe in all of that. The third thing is, Al-Imanu bil-Kutubi, to believe in the books. What does it mean to believe in the books? You believe...